Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine. Heroes of salvation, marches of God. What a receiving. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and relate to this morning that you've given us. We thank you, Lord, that you have a plan for us, God, and we have this assurance that you are our God. Lord, this is our story. This is our song this morning. The Lord, you are still our Savior. You are still our God. And you are still my Father, Lord, fighting on our behalf in your glory. We will praise you and lift you and worship you, God. How we pray the Lord is going to speak to us. How we pray the Lord is going to lift us. How we pray the Lord is going to be our God and our guide this morning. Speak to us, trust Lord, that because you are listening. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Everybody say,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Our text today is in Joshua chapter 24, verse 14 to 18. The reading I read, and it's also good that we read, that we connect together. Now, therefore, fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your fathers served beyond the river in Egypt, and serve the Lord. Verse 15. And if it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods of your fathers served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Then the people answered, far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve your other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our fathers up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight, and preserved us in all the way that we went. And among all the peoples through whom we passed, and the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who live in the land. Therefore, we will also serve the Lord, for he is our God. Our topic today is when God becomes the priority. When Jesus is given, it is when the creator of the universe, when the King of glory, when our Father becomes priority in our life. We live in a world and in a system that has priorities on other things. We live in a world that has changed, whereby we have priorities upside down. But this morning I'd like us to share about when God becomes the priority. Let's learn the meaning of priority. It is the fact or the condition of being regarded or treated as more important than others. I want to read it again. It is the fact or condition of being regarded or treated as more important than others. It's been, I remember, 3 years ago, I was working on a health department. whereby our work was get a form from a member and then we process it. And then we credit the money in the member's account for their use. We were using physical forms at that particular time. And whenever you go to your outfit, what you are looking early in the morning is for the word P on a member's form. It means priority. Maybe a sick member, maybe coming from the highest ranks, doesn't matter. Once you see a P, nobody will remind you what that means. It means it was the first case that we worked on. It is a case that is supposed to be worked on that day. Let there be no call finding out why that particular case has not been worked on, because it means priority. When God becomes priority, priority means there are options to choose from. On our options, whatever you can choose from. Israelites have an option of serving God or their forefathers or serving the living God. This is Joshua speaking. And there, Wajaman, Mutachagua, you will have to make a choice on who you will serve. For the children of Israel. And as we saw last Sunday, we saw the miracles, some of the miracles that God had done for these people. But they were where they were because of God and nothing else. But along the way, they started making choices of other things. Along the way, their priorities changed. Along the way, they wanted to serve other gods, and they declare that these other gods, these are the gods that took us from the land of Egypt. And the Joshua is looking at them and telling them, guys, you cannot forget. But I have to say this, it is not something that we are going to force down to you. It is something that we are going to have to make a choice this day whom you shall serve. In verse 15, now let's read it. And if it is evil in your heart to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods of your fathers served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But listen, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. When Jesus is here, Joshua had made a decision. It doesn't matter the direction of life. It doesn't matter what you are doing in your millions. I have made a decision that I'm going to serve the Lord. So I've got to make a decision. You have to make a choice between light and darkness. You have to make a choice between life with God and the life without God. And the third thing is you have to make a choice between dependence on God or independence. Independence of putting some marks. Meaning, that is not the independence God will want. He's telling them, make a choice between light and darkness. Between knowing where you're going or just moving in darkness without knowing where you're going. Make a choice between life with God. Life whereby your life is controlled by God or life without God. Make a choice between depending on God, everything in your life, or independence. Why make God a priority? Why make God a priority? I will not call you out to make God. I will not call you that. But I'm going to look at the why. The first thing is when you make God a priority, you will enjoy supernatural benefits. It's the ideas that people process. They depend a lot on intelligence to take action. we are fighting the coronavirus. Is that glory? We are so much depending on intel from the researchers. But this is the fear. So that we can make the next decision. When God becomes your priority, right, you will enjoy supernatural benefits. There was the case of Joseph and Mary. On another point, life is good. But Herod is looking to kill the child. The angel of God comes and appears to Joseph and appears to him. Look, it's time for me. It was not a soldier from Herod. It was not a natural being that went to wake up Joseph and Mary. And I'm here saying, at this chapter 10, you need to live right now. We have Elisha. The king is having a cabinet meeting. And I'm here, Jama, who is sharing our secret with Israelites? Anything that we discuss, they part in the figure for Israelites. What is happening? Then, one wise man, anamwambia Elisha. Huyu jamaa anataka Elisha. Whatever you say in your bedroom, it is brought to the king of Israel. How? Because Elisha made God a priority. And he took something called supernatural deliverance. Let me tell you something. Some of us here are working in jobs, in businesses, whatever it is that we're doing. If we are going to be super successful, we must, and I like the word, we must depend on God's intelligence. On when to do something, when to plan, when to go for that deal, and when not to go for that journey. When to go for something, you must depend on God's intelligence. The young people who are related, you cannot use your eyes. Make God your priority. Na Mungu atakujenga. He will find you, sort your house. You will enjoy supernatural gifts. Let me go to the next one. The second one, you get fed from the kitchen of heaven. Unapula chakula ya mbinguni. Now, I don't know if it's a kitchen of heaven. But when you read the Bible, unaambiwa utakuwa na laki saba. Hallelujah. It must be prepared somewhere. You get fed from the kitchen of heaven. Elijah and the ravens. Jamal is there. And he is really hungry. And God sends ravens. These guys eat meat. God will give Elijah. When he says, you get fed from the kitchen of heaven. You don't beg anything. You only go before the Lord telling God, I'm in this situation. Come for my blessing. But friends, is a condition. You must make God your priority. The other thing is, you develop extraordinary boldness. There were three guys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The king has given an order that you must worship this particular monument or whatever it is that he has said. And the three guys said, we will not. I don't have. And when other kings, when other officials are bowing, when everybody in this particular land is bowing, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and Amandia, because we know our we know where we belong. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when I was before the king, and I was a man, and I was a man, and I was a man, and the liberal king, we will not serve your God. Let it be known to you. I said, that is another level of God. Then I called the leaders, and I said, we will not. And I told the man, you are sure you are going, you are there, even before you speak. Now we are getting to know that we will not serve this king. Because our priority has the ability of saving us from you. Our priority has the ability of saving us from you. But even if it doesn't, would you be not waiting?
No, we will not have.
That is the extraordinary bondage. We are living to face life today. We go through some situations. Now, let it be known that I will not do this. I will not. There are consequences that are waiting for you if you do it. David and Goliath. When David is engaging Goliath, he was not a trained army person. When we read the Bible, we realize that he was just a mere young man keeping sheep over. That was his level. And the two masses of the brothers are good. They are trained. They are huge people. And as he goes there, he goes. They go to the king. They give me an opportunity. And when they meet, you come against me with a javelin, with a sword, with a shield. But I come against you in the name of our God, who you defied. Mamabia, even though your priority is I know who is my priority. It's called you're going to be able to develop an extra bonus. Hallelujah! Another thing is, when you make God your priority, you stay away from sin. Anybody? You develop some muscles to stay away from sin. Anybody? We've Christians that have compromised the work of God. Every Christian that, yeah, we are in church. But where we find ourselves in other days, where we find ourselves when we are not in church, we will not trust anybody in the sin. We call it life. We have a case of Joseph and the Potiphar's wife. He had an opportunity, but he realized this is an opportunity to mess up my destiny. He deliberately said, no. Doesn't matter the offer, but are you going to be ready to say no? You see, of course, you will not be easy. Of course, you will find it challenging. But when God is your priority, you will be able to choose to stay away from sin. The fifth point, it is impossibilities than possibilities. What has been saying that this is impossible? This cannot happen. This is not possible for you. Miraculously, it becomes possible. Friends, it's high time that we start going for goals that are extraordinary. It is high time that we start setting standards that are beyond us. Who to share where you are going? But say, I'm not the president of this country. And I want to let my patients have this in the problem. I don't know what to do for breakfast. But I don't know. That is possible. But that's the level where God wants you to go. You need to start writing the amount you need to be earning every year to the other year. You know, when you talk to me, I want you to survive. What a devil. Where's the place to survive? We need to have some goals. But this was secured. We didn't say every man an easy amount of money. I wonder what to do. You look at what you've written and it's okay. It doesn't look real. God is faithful. But this was secured. Yeah, you won't be making a million every other man. But you can't. Possibilities. You need to write it and then believe it. If you have to talk about what's at the ground and then. What are you going to do? You need to say that Before I die, I need to travel in every continent except Antarctica. And I want to put my feet on every continent. Looks like an impossibility, but you need to start setting some heavy things. You need to start saying, this is the car I want to drive. This is where I am, but this is where I am going. It must be impossible. What you call it? It's what is simple. Jesus, one of the disciples, Nana, is in this particular text, imagining me, speaking about the kingdom of heaven. Now, here. The disciples of Nana, these are this is impossible. But in God, that is possible. But this was the thing. This one, really understand this particular passage. You are looking at your life. What you see is impossible. Oh, what you're saying, unafanya mahesabu, unafika mwisho. What are you doing with this God? The God that's going to give you some extra points. This God that's going to turn impossibility to possibilities. What are you making of your life? Why don't you spend more time with this God? Why don't you spend more time with this world and see what happens? You know, unless this thing may not have happened here, unless it has happened on your life, it will be another story that is spoken on spirit, that is spoken from another point. But what about two speaking to God? What is your sin? Friends, our focus is God. The ceiling is not the place. Is God as a reality? Because He is not a reality. All that was seen, the men in you were just the Lord blesses. May the Lord meet us as a Sabbath. And may the Lord meet you as an individual is to make him the priority. Yes. Father, we thank you because of this morning. Lord, you brought us one thing to make you a priority in our life, to make you a priority in our body. To make your priority, God, in our speech, in our plan. My Father, we've seen five benefits of a good idea. Lord, we know that thousands and thousands in store for us if we're going to focus on you. We lift you, God, and we thank you because of faith and because of riches. Lord, as we digest this particular word, we pray that Lord is going to be a fruit. It's going to build us, Lord. And my Father, one focus we shall have. And ask to make you. And it is in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the Lord bless us.